didn't even spot in that Revolutionary War for the issues stated in the Declaration of Independence. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal.
We were listed only as property, not people. We could not write our own names because we didn't know how to write. And now, it seems time has forgotten our names.
I was born the property of Benjamin Turner. I had a vision. I saw white spirits and black spirits engaged in battle. The sun darkened. The thunder rolled in the heavens. Blood flowed in streams. I heard a voice saying, "Such is your luck. Such you are called to see it. Let it come rough or smooth. You must surely bear it."
There was pity in her glance at me. She gave me a large ginger cake. That night I learned that I was not only a child, but somebody's child. The sweet cake my mother gave me was in the shape of a heart. On my mother's knee, I was a king upon his throne, but my triumph was short. I dropped off to sleep and waked in the morning only to find my mother gone.
Ain't I a woman? I have as much muscle as any man and could do as much work as any man. I have plowed and reaped and husked and chopped and mowed. Can any man do more than that? I tell you, the meanest child of glory outshines the brightest sun.
I was only 7 years old when I was sent away to take care of a white baby. One morning, I stood by the table, waiting till I was to take it. And just by me was a bowl of lumps of white sugar. I never had nothing good. And that sugar did look so nice, and my missus' back was turned to me. So I just put my fingers in the sugar bowl to take one lump. And she turned and saw me. The next minute, she had the rawhide down.
But many of us color folk wanted a better life if we can find one. I was raised a slave and had a master to tell me what to do. He gave me a place to sleep, fed, clothed, and worked me. Sometimes I got whipped, and my master would give me a big kick in the pants if I slept off, made a mistake, or if I was lazy. Slavery's been around for a long time, and us colored folk got sold like we was a horse, cow, or some other animal.
I do not believe that any state should make a law that permits an ignorant, poverty-stricken white man to vote and prevents a black man in the same condition from voting. It will become apparent that the white man begins by cheating a Negro out of his ballot, soon learns to cheat a white man out of his.
December 5th, 1955 was one of the memorable and inspiring days of my life. History records this day as the beginning of the modern civil rights movement that transformed and influenced freedom revolutions around the world. I had been arrested 4 days earlier in my hometown of Montgomery, Alabama, for refusing to give up my seat on a city bus for a white man, which was a much resented customary practice at the time.
I am in Birmingham because injustice is here. I am compelled to carry the gospel of freedom beyond my hometown. I cannot sit idly in Atlanta and not be concerned of what happened in Birmingham. Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. I have a dream that someday my four little children will be judged not by the color of their skin, but the content of their character. I have a dream today.
Let America be America again. Let it be the dream it used to be. Let it be the pioneer on the plain seeking a home where he himself is free.
America was never America to me.
Let America be the dream dreamers dream. Let it be that great strong land of love where never kings connive nor tyrants scheme, that any man be crushed by one above.
It was never America to me.
My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land.
Martin, a 17-year-old victim of and his perpetrator is not doing time.
Thank you.
And to get any attention from the powers that be is to get a petition signed in America. America? America. America. God shed his grace on thee and crown the next black president. Or will the sad superior race continue to take precedence? Because racism, even though we've come a long way, is still evident. Trayvon had dreams like Martin Luther King, but neither one of them will come true if a young black boy or girl can get killed under the nation's flag, red, white, and blue. Wow. And the perpetrator not be subdued? Ooh. My country, 'tis of thee. Zimmer does not deserve to have man attached to his name. Somebody replace it with fool.
Woo! I will. All right.
Zimmer does not deserve to have man attached to his name. Somebody replace it with fool. I read that he was justified to do what he was set out to do, which was kill an innocent black boy. So tell me, what did he do? I heard that he judged Trayvon Martin by his skin, but he was judged too. I read that he was justified to do what he set out to do. Sweet land of liberty. So, but he broke the rules by walking through a suburban neighborhood, wearing his hoodie, carrying Skittles and a tea brew. So tell me, what did he do? The killer's words were, coons always get away. No, you got away. Right. By the way he judged Trayvon Martin by the color of his skin, how is it that he gets a slap on the hand with no reprimand? America, America, God shed his grace on thee. Time and justice is served, but a plea for reform goes unheard. My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land where Trayvon Martin died, stripped of his very life, Skittles lay by his side. Let freedom.
It's in a world that black lives matter. But when are black lives going to matter to black people?
I am confused and afraid. I wonder what path I will take. I hear there are only two ways out. I see mothers bury their sons. I want my mom to never feel that pain. I am confused and afraid.
I pretend all is fine. I feel like I'm suffocating. I touch nothing, so I believe all is fine. I worry that it isn't, though. I cry no more. I'm confused and afraid.
I understand people believe I'm just a statistic. I tell them I'm different. I dream of life getting easier. I try my best to make my dream come true. I hope it does. I am confused and afraid. I was Anton Rose Jr. Rest in peace.
Women as underclass. But we all know that the reality is far different than what is being portrayed. Let me give you a few examples of real life people. Ella Baker, who is she? A civil rights activist that worked behind the scenes for the—
I'm nice, I'm funny, I'm fun, I'm unique.
I'm me.
When I finish high school, I'm gonna go to college to pursue my dream career acting. I'm gonna show people that they didn't break me down. They lifted me up just to prove them wrong. I am Martina Miller, and this is my Black experience. Thank you.
Live their dream to do something great, to use those things for the greater good. Yes, for the greater good. Because I know my Black is beautiful, and with the help of my Black people, we can make a change.
Good evening. My name is, I'm Mac. And I want to talk about role models. I had two.
I leave you love. Love built is positive and helpful.
It is more beneficial than hate. Injuries are quickly forgotten and passed away.
Personally and racially, our enemies must be forgiven.
Our aim is to create a world of fellowship and justice where no man's skin color or religion is held against him.
Love thy neighbor is a precept which can transform the world if it was universally practiced.
It connotes brotherhood, and to me, brotherhood of man is the noblest concept in all human relations.
Loving your neighbor means being interracial, interreligious, and international.
Now, there are sit-ins, there are marches, there are fists in the air, there are riots, all of which are coming against something you're not happy with. Some are effective, some are not. Tonight, I want to talk to you about an effective protest. The Greensboro Four, North Carolina A&T freshmen, waged the most powerful protest in the history of this country.
To keep a mirror near to make sure that my nose is not getting bigger. The most frightening thought is that if I'm still growing, then my nose must still be growing. If this is true, I will soon be able to suck in the world. I want a small, dainty nose. I want a nose that is nice and slim, not a lump of clay that sits on my face with two large holes in it. My nose.
I'm tall! Too tall!
I'm short! Can you see me?
I'm the tallest person that I know! Being tall may be good on the court, but I don't even like to play basketball! I like to read, write, and I love math! No one looks at me for the person that I am! They only see me
mumble. I will always speak clearly. I'll stand proud and never let my head hang low. But through some trick of nature, I have ended up with big lips. Not just big lips, but extra big lips.
You think your lips are large? Look at mine. I know my lips are larger than yours. If I had small, nice, thin lips, I would wear bright pink lipstick and kiss everyone I meet. I would smile with grace and beauty. I know I have the largest lips in the world.
No, my lips are larger.
See me? Can anyone see me? Nose too flat, lips too big, and he has a nerve to complain about being too tall. Can you see me? Can anyone?
What's wrong with you?
Yeah, what's wrong with you?
And?
My lips are big. I have my own problems.
Everyone is going to say, isn't he cute? Oh, look at that little boy. I'm tired. I'm 9 years old.
me and they think, look at that fat girl or big girl. I want to be thin. I want to be thin.
Can you be quiet? I have a mental thing that you can fall on my shoulder and fall down the street.
Myself. Look deep into my mirror. What do you see?
I see my mama. She has a nose like mine.
What do you see?
My grandmother has big lips. I love my grandmother.
What do you see?
I see my whole family. My mother is short, my father is short, grandma is short. Everyone I love is short. I see them all in me.
When I look into my mirror, I see pride, dignity, and love. My ancestors fought to survive so that I could be here today. I must be proud. I must always walk with my head held high. Future, and I'll continue to fight, learn, grow, and survive. We must be proud of our flat noses and big lips. What do you see in your mirror?
I see beautiful, beautiful black me. What's wrong with me? Nothing's wrong with me.
Their performance in the musical number Jump and Jive with Cab Calloway and his orchestra featured in the movie Stormy Weather is considered by many to be the most virtuosic dance display of all times. I present to you the Nicholas Brothers. This morning with my mind, oh,
state of freedom.
Whoa. I woke up this morning with my mind, yes I did.
State of freedom.
Let me say,
hallelujah,
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 hallelujah.
One more time. Hey.
Music has always played a central role in our lives. It tells the story of our people's journey through history, our struggles, accomplishments, our joys, and our sorrows. I'd like to talk about the music I remember growing up to. Not just any kind of music, but movement music, protest music, and black pride music.
There's a train a coming. You don't need no baggage. You just get on board. All you need is faith to hear the Jesus coming. You don't need no ticket. You just thank the Lord.
Hey, black child, do you know who you are? Who you really? What you want to be, if you try to be, you can be.
Hey, black child, do you know where you're going, where you're really going? Do you know you can learn what you want to learn, if you try to learn what you can learn?
Hey, black child, do you know you are strong? I mean, really strong. Do you know you can do what you want to do, if you try to do what you can do?
Hey, black child, be what you could.
Ah!
that I was once wrongfully accused back in the 70s. So I fled the country, put me on the FBI's most wanted list. Eventually, I was captured, but I am free and cleared of all charges. I am an African-American woman. I am a scholar, activist, writer, educator, politician, organizer. Who am I? I am Angela Davis. Power to the people.
One day I'll be a successful veterinarian and be able to help any animals that's in need.
I have a dream that when I grow up, I'll be a professional basketball player. If I make it to the NBA, I'll be able to help out with the kids in my community and inspire kids like I once was by my favorite basketball players.
I have a dream that one day I will become a nurse. I have a so that I can assist in helping people with their medical issues. Therefore, doing what I enjoy, that also gives me a sense of fulfillment.
I have a dream
that one day the nation will rise and live out the true meanings of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident and that all men are created equal. Sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down at the table of brotherhood.
I have a dream
that children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin but by the continent of the caravan.
Negroes are no good for the economy, so they must be broken and tied together for orderly production. William Lynch said this in 1712. 300 years. For 300 years, we've been advocating to stop police brutality.
300 years, we've been fighting to supremacy and racism. 300 years, we've been marching to stop the cruel, unusual punishment of African Americans.
No one's perfect, but no one's worthless. Yet, it's a huge deal when white people are dying. But whenever it's our black lives, we're silenced. Mm.
No life is worth more than another. Not because of race, not because of age, not because of color, not because of gender. Whether you're young or old, light or dark, male or female, no life is worthless.
Why did you make me black, God? Why did you make me black? Why would you make me someone the world will hold back? Black is the color of dirty clothes and grimy hands and feet. Black is the color of darkness from tired beasts.
Black is the color of the bruised eye when someone gets hurt. Black is the color of darkness. Black is the color of dirt.
Why did you make me black? Why did you make my bone structure so thick and my cheeks and hips so high? Why did you make my eyes brown and not the color of the sky?
Why do people think I'm useless? How come I feel so used? Why do people see my skin and think I should be abused?
Black is what people are labeled and others want to keep them away. Black is the color of shadows cast. Black is the end of the day.
Lord, I just don't understand. What is it about my skin? Why do they want to hate me and not know the person within?
Lord, you know my own people mistreat me. You know this just ain't right. They don't like my hair. They don't like my skin. As they say, I'm too dark or too light. Lord, you know it's time to make a change. Why can't you make creation the same?
Why did I make you black? I made you in the color of coal, from which beautiful diamonds are formed. I made you in the color of oil, the black gold, which keeps people warm. Your color is the same as the rich dark soil that grows the food you need. Your color is the same as the black stallion and panther. Oh, what majestic creatures indeed. All colors of the heavenly rainbow can be found throughout every nation. When all these colors are blended, you become my greatest creation. Your hair is the texture of lamb's wool. Such a beautiful creature is he. I am the shepherd who watches them. I will always watch over thee. You are the color of the midnight sky. I put star glitter in your eyes. There's a beautiful smile hidden behind your pain. That's why your cheeks are so high. You are the color of dark clouds from the hurricanes I create in September. I made your lips so full and thick, so when you kiss, they will remember. Your stature is strong, your bone structure thick, to withstand the burden of time. The reflection you see in the mirror, that image that looks back, that is mine. So get off your knees. Look in the mirror and tell me what you see. I didn't make you in the image of darkness. I made you in the image of me.
Maya Angelou said, "Leaving behind nights of terror and fear, I rise into a daybreak that's so wondrously clear, I rise. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave, I am the hope and the dream of the slave. I rise.
I rise.
I rise.
I rise.
And in 2020, still, I rise.
To the wall of Fort Wagner, urging his fellow troops to follow him. He planted the flag in the sand at the base of the fort, and he held it upright until his near lifeless body was rescued. Even though he didn't give it up, many witnesses say Kearny refused to give the flag to any of his rescuers, holding on to it tightly until assistance had made its way to the temporary barracks. Kearny lost a lot of the blood, lost a lot of his blood, and lost his life. But not once did he allow the flag to touch the ground. His heroic inspiration to other soldiers that day were crucial in the North having victory at Fort Wagner.
Sergeant William Kearny, who was presented with the Medal of Honor, was presented with this medal May the 23rd in the year 1900 for the bravery that he displayed.
Be proud of what you are. Believe me, it will always take you very far.
black woman whose four parents were once a slave, if you apply yourself, you can have it made. Black woman, you are clean, modest, and neat. Believe me, black woman, you can't be beat. Black woman, always watch what you do, because being black means everyone else is watching you.
But did you finish? Yeah, but I fell and I scraped my knee. But did you finish? Yeah, but all my friends left me and they stopped cheering for me. But did you finish? Yeah, but I'm in pain, Dad. But did you finish? Yeah, but I'm hurt, Dad. But did you finish? Yeah, but that young black man, you finished. Regardless of the obstacles at the forefront of your obstacles, you handled a disadvantage that will systematically falter you. Run, black boy, run. Not running through to the finish line would diminish the efforts of the patriarchs of the past who placed you in the privileged position to even run in the first place. You better run, black boy, run. I demand that our reparations be given to us in the form of education so that our children's paces can be brought down to a more even placement. Then say that you're smarter than our sons. Then say that you're better than our daughters. Then say that you're more resilient than our people. Until the K-12 pipeline to preeminence is radically reformed through the process of reparations, our children will continue to be at a 400-pace disadvantage. Son, I may not get there with you. But if I know my God, and let me say that I do, one day you will get there. But until that glorious day when God opens up the heavens and enables our people to obtain that thing we have fought for, that we have bled for, that we have died for 400 years, son, young black man, future Morehouse man, future Howard University man, future Tuskegee Institute man, future FAMU man, you better keep them legs turning and ignore what the world tells you that you should be. You better keep those arms pumping and ignore what the world tells you that you can't do, and you better run. You better run. You better run. Black boy, run.
In spite of what's going on socially, which you should be aware of, you should be aware of all the things that are going on, all of the laws, all of the regulations that are being passed, because we're not gonna stand for that. We're gonna stand up for our rights. Is anybody ready to stand up? So, say it loud. So in spite of the things that happened, tonight we have made history once again. Viola Davis became the first black actor to win an Oscar, Emmy, and a Tony tonight. Come on.
And as I was listening to the children, I had a flashback to my early years as a young boy in Mississippi. Especially when they was talking about the African American that owned their own farms. And I remember that my granddad and grandmother was farmers. And they would take their produce to market. And as soon as they got there, the price went down. And all of their work for that whole year was just destroyed. My granddad sometime would come back and dump the produce in the field. He said, I refuse to give it to him for nothing.
Soon I will be done with the troubles of this world. Troubles of this world. Soon I will be done with the troubles of this world. I'm going home to live with God. done with the troubles of this world. Troubles of this world. Troubles of this world. Soon I will be done with the troubles of this world. I'm going home to live with God. No more weeping and wailing. There will be no more weeping.
When I love this shade so much. My color is dark and lovely. It seems things with arithmetic melody.
My black is loud. It yelled at this pale-faced lady the other day. She tried to send me my black. And just as quickly as she did, my black screamed back. It roared with elegance, reminding you it wasn't afraid anymore.
My black is hopeful. I've had a freedom that was honestly free. I've lived in a time when my black was okay. My black lives today safely from oppression, though still hated on. But my black believes in a better tomorrow, still lives of dreams of liberation and equality. My black has a great future.
All right. All right.
My black is an artist, thoughtfully chosen to be just this. Not chocolate, not sweet, or bitter. My deep and rich black is still unmatched, nothing as dark. It masterfully enhances my natural look.
My black is resilient, offended and hurt in the past. The complexities of this complexion cannot be understood. I took out my black for a day and was terribly made fun of growing up. People hold no discretion or reservation against my black. As though a fugitive, my black has been ostracized, attacked, found guilty, yet still fought back, rising against contempt of others. My black isn't weak, and it advocates me. My black isn't always easy, but I am my black, and my black is me.
Proverbs 101. The Proverbs of Solomon, the son of David, the king of Israel, to know wisdom, to know instruction, to receive the words of understanding, to receive instruction of wisdom and justice, Yeah, don't forget judgment. Yeah, don't forget equity.
Yeah, this is America. Guns in my area. I got the strap. I gotta carry 'em. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go into this. Yeah, yeah, this is gorilla. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go get the bag. Yeah, yeah, or I'ma get the pad. Yeah, yeah, I'm so cold like, yeah. I'm so dull like, yeah. We gon' blow like, yeah. Slipping up, look what I'm whipping up. This is America. Don't catch you slipping up. Don't catch you slipping up. Look what I'm whipping up. Look how I'm geeking up. I'm so pretty. I'm on Gucci. I'm so pretty.
Yeah,
I'm on get it. Watch me move. This is Sally. That's a tool.
Yeah.
On my Kodak. Black. Know that.
Yeah.
Ooh, get it. Yeah. Work it. Yeah. 100 bands. 100 bands. Contraband. I got the plug on a hawker.
Whoa.
They gonna find you like baka blah.
Proceeded to grab my body and slam my face to the pavement. I quickly realized I have no rights. Why don't I have any rights? I wanted to be treated like everybody else. I wanted to be treated equally. And now I'm a victim. Why am I gone? I didn't know this would be my last day. Things would be so different. I just wanted my justice. I knew my rights. Know your rights. Exercise your rights and fight for you. Pay attention and do not let my death be in vain. As my mommy said, I am an activist. I am sassy. I am smart. And I knew my rights. Know your rights.
All you can count on is yourself, little girl, little lady.
I see the sparkle in your eyes. I can't wait to see you fly, little lady. Life is but a dream right now. Go by 10 turns to 15, and before you know you're 25, your heart's been broken and you're terrified.
Little lady,
gently down the stream,
Miss Sadie,
merrily, merrily, merrily.
Little lady,
life is but a dream,
Miss Sadie. Little lady,
ooh, just a little girl,
Miss Sadie,
grown up in the cold, cold
little
world.
Lady,
but nothing's what it seems.
Sadie, little lady.
Lies, deception, and false truths are the substitutes of what used to be your lullabies. Can't distinguish the laughter from the cries. Bag
lights under your eyes, so you use makeup to cover up what you cannot hide. Then you have daughters and then they have sons who have daughters, and those are the ones who have the opportunity to break the curses that make their mothers buy purses with letters on them to show that they're not worth less. We did it. We dropped the ball like a million times, ladies, I admit it. The blame's on man, no need to split the difference. But God's raising up men who really get it. We got the same haircuts, the same clothes, but trust me, baby girl, something's different. It's accepting that we're not in control. Giving our lives to the one who is, he wipes our noses and subdue our fears. Cause honestly, that's all it really is. In our youth, we had hopes too, but some heroes never ever appear. Gently down the stream,
Miss Sadie,
merrily, merrily.
Little lady,
life is but a dream.
Miss Sadie, little lady,
oh, you're just a little girl.
Miss Sadie,
grown up in the cocoa world.
Little lady,
well, nothing's what it seems.
Miss Sadie, sit down and count the snowdrops falling.
Martin didn't stand up. What if Rosa didn't sit down? What if Malcolm didn't man up? Where would we be now? What if Molly didn't get up, stand up? What if Du Bois didn't come to advance us? And Mandela didn't come to teach us? Where would we be now? Langston Hughes didn't write it down.